Hello, everyone. I'm delighted to be here to talk to you about the next wave of innovation for Microsoft Teams that will make collaboration even more seamless, whether you're still working from home remotely or you're back in office. Number one, how we're making it easy for you to bring your teams together and reduce the meetings fatigue. Second, how we're addressing some of the known pain points in the way meetings are structured today. And then lastly, how we're streamlining your work and saving you time every day. With that, let's jump into it. Now, once I'm in a meeting, you'll see the new dynamic view. It's a more fluid and flexible way to optimize the screen real estate for what's most important. So if someone's sharing content or people who are joining through video are the main part of my screen here. The audio-only participants are on the right-hand side, so the focus can stay on people who are joining through video. Now, we've also added visual cues to easily follow along the meeting participants.
As you'll see when I'm talking, a purple box will appear above my head.
And I see James has just raised hand, and his box is highlighted in yellow. Now we know there are times where you have to bring a large group of people together for interactive meeting. Think of a company town hall. Not only will Teams support up to 1,000 meeting participants, we're making the experience more scalable with up to 20,000 more people who can attend as viewers in addition to those 1,000 participants. Now, when someone's presenting content in the meeting, you can see the content as well as the meeting participants in the same view. As the content's getting shared, you also want to be able to focus on a particular person. It could be an interpreter, it could be a decision maker, or maybe a conference room where a bunch of people are joining together. It's just a great way for us to bring content and people together in the same view in a meeting. Now, as you can see, I have 9 meeting participants on my screen. We call it the gallery view. As more people start joining, we'll optimize for the most active meeting participants. However, now, you also have the option to select the large gallery view that supports up to 49 people. So here, you can see 16 people on my screen. Now let's see what it looks like when we have 25 people on the screen. And last but not the least, 49 people at the same time on the same screen. It's just another way for us to give you greater control on your meeting experience. Now, I'm not sure about you, but I'm in so many video meetings these days that it can be overwhelming. We believe there is a better way for video meetings to help us stay more connected. This month, we're excited to announce a new meetings capability called Together Mode that brings you and your team members in the same shared virtual space without any barriers. Just with one click, I can convert the meeting setup into an auditorium-like setting where me and my colleagues can be in a much more natural setup. Think of meetings like a brainstorming session or a live teaching session. It's just a more natural and relaxed way to be with your colleagues and friends. In addition to the auditorium setting, we will be bringing more settings to this experience. Think of a classroom, a conference room, or a cafe. Now let's see what this looks like when we have more people joining in. Now you'll see, as I'm speaking, people are looking at my direction. When someone starts speaking, everyone's gaze is directed towards them.
And by removing the distraction of individual backgrounds, our brains can actually more easily focus on the people themselves. And we can catch nonverbal cues like head nods or raised eyebrows, smiling, or a raised hand.
Since it's easier to understand from people's body language when they want to speak, it just makes for a seamless, more easy handoff between speakers. It just leads to this more human connection between people, which is essentially missing from today's meetings experience. Now, this experience also scales up to 49 people at the same time. From everyday meeting, to a classroom, to your next big event, it feels like all of us are together, even when we are apart. Now, I know all of you have been itching to have some fun, so let's give each other some high fives. Another new feature that helps me stay connected with my team members is Reflect. It's a messaging extension which team leaders and class instructors can use to take a quick pulse of their team members to see how everyone's doing. So here, when I go in the menu, I can see the Reflect tool. I can create a question or select from one of the predefined questions. I can select the privacy settings, whether I want the results to be anonymous or public. I can also decide if it's a recurring poll. Once I submit the poll, it actually goes into a channel and all my team members can vote on it. That's just a quick way for me to connect with my team and check in on them. Now, let me pass it on to my colleague, Deandra, who's going to talk to you about Teams innovations that can help address meetings pain points. Over to you, Deandra.
As Karan noted, more and more meetings are taking place virtually. For me personally, I always find it really challenging to read the reactions of those that I'm on a call with. Let me share with you all some new and exciting features coming to Teams to help with these meeting pain points. With the raised hand feature, we can ensure that all voices have been heard. And if you're running late to a meeting, you don't have to worry about if folks did or didn't see your message. With chat bubbles, your message will now pop up right within the meeting view for all participants to see. We're bringing exciting ways to love, celebrate, and laugh together as a team with live reactions. If you really love something that someone shared, send over a love reaction. If you want to celebrate a big win as a team, now the team can celebrate back with you. This is a really great authentic way to bring group sentiment into the digital meeting experience. Many of us have been using live captions to follow along with the conversation during our Teams meetings. But before, we had no way of knowing who was saying what. This was particularly challenging in environments where it was hard to hear. What you'll see now as I turn on live captions is that it will not only capture what is being shared, but also who is sharing it.
Which is super handy when someone is presenting and you don't actually know who's talking.
That's right, Jason. Especially in those meetings with unfamiliar faces, you're able to stay more connected than ever by knowing everyone and their name. This is available now in English, with more languages coming soon. I'm going to go ahead and walk you guys through a new feature we're also adding, live transcription. You'll see here as I turn on live transcription that it'll capture the comments that were made throughout this conversation, as well as be providing a really good recap tool after the meeting takes place. You'll also see up here at the top that Teams will notify all meeting participants that they're being transcribed once the feature is enabled. This is a really great way to know what is being said during a conversation and who is making those decisions.
And it can also help in those embarrassing moments when you got distracted just as a question was being asked to you.
Exactly. Now you can quickly read up through the captions and be able to catch yourself up and respond really quickly. And then after the meeting, all of this is available for you. When you open up the meeting chat, the transcriptions live right there. Once you open up the transcription, you'll be able to see the decisions that were made, who made them, and the context around the entire conversation. This is going to be a very powerful tool to know how we can better follow up with meetings afterwards and be more efficient. I'm going to pass it back over to Karan, who's going to wrap up with how Teams can help streamline your work and save you time.
Great stuff. Thank you, Deandra. Now, with Microsoft 365 and Teams, we're continuously looking for ways to streamline your work and save you time. Now, my mobile phone is a key part of my everyday routine. Whether I'm at home taking a break from my laptop, or just out running an errand, this is how I keep on top of things that I have to do. Cortana is my digital voice assistant that uses AI and Microsoft Graph to securely take actions like getting in touch with people or finding the right files while I'm on the go. I can use microphone in my Teams mobile app to interact naturally with Cortana. Let's take a look. What's in my schedule tomorrow morning?
I'm finding one event for tomorrow morning.
Oh, I see. There's a meeting in the morning, and I promised Marissa I'll send her a file before this. Well, let me just do it now while I'm on the go. Send the quarterly review deck to Marissa.
Okay, which PowerPoint should I share?
The second one. Now you'll see, I didn't have to say the exact name of the presentation or Marissa's full name. That's because Cortana understands the signals from Microsoft Graph, so it really understands what my recent activities are and who are my key contacts. You can take numerous actions like this with Cortana, like making a call, scheduling a meeting, or sending a message. So here, I can just send a message to my next meeting participants. Send a message to my next meeting.
All right, what's your message?
Please send the agenda for tomorrow's meeting.
Send it or change it.
Send.
I'll send that.
Let me show you a couple of other features that are already available in Teams, but help manage your work-life balance and personal well-being. Continuing on the theme of Cortana, it also sends me a daily briefing email every morning. It captures all the upcoming appointments, as well as any commitments that I might have made to colleagues in the previous emails. Now, if you actually scroll down to the bottom, it proactively asks me if I want to block some time for focusing. So here, I'll go ahead and block 3 to 4 p.m. Now, you can see on my calendar the times blocked as focus time. When I do that, there are two things that happen. One, all my contacts on Teams see my status as focused. And second, all the notifications are silenced for that time, unless I've given someone explicit permission to be able to send me a message at that time. With around-the-clock access to mobile phone, it's become even more important to be able to balance work and life. In the Teams mobile app, I can easily schedule quiet hours. So here, you'll see I've blocked 7 p.m. to 7 a.m., during which time I don't get any notifications. If I actually want to customize the time to a later point, I can do that in a very easy way as well. During this time, I can just stay focused on my personal well-being. Another time saver that I use every day is suggested replies. So when someone sends you a message on Teams chat, the application provides you logical responses. It may be a small thing, but the benefit adds up over time. While I'm in the focus mode, I can use the new Tasks app within Teams to manage all my action items. It brings together tasks from To-Do and Planner in one simple view. Smart views like Important, Planned, and Assigned to Me create a structured, curated view of my action items. So for example, when I go to the Important tab, I can select one of the action items and change the status to Completed. The Tasks app within Teams is also available on your mobile phone, so you can manage your tasks while you're on the go. This is the Microsoft Teams display, an ambient touchscreen with a hands-free experience powered by Cortana. It's an all-in-one device, so it brings all your favorite Teams experiences like chats, meetings, calling, calendar, files, all in one single place. And it also seamlessly connects with your PC. Since it's paired with my laptop, it's a companion device. So as soon as I unlock my PC, you'll see the Microsoft Teams display also gets unlocked. Now you can see that I can access my chats and notifications in a single glance. Here, I see my peer Lydia has sent me a message. She actually wants me to review a deck. Now, since it's a companion device, I can actually open up the document on my PC for a richer experience. Now, in meetings, the Teams display device works better together with your PC, so you can have a distributed meetings experience across the devices. You know, you could be sharing content on one device, and you could be following along with your participants on another device. Now, of course, I can join a meeting by pressing a button on Teams display. But since this device actually supports Cortana, I can also take hands-free actions while I'm just walking up to my device. Let's take a look. Hey, Cortana. Join my next meeting.
Joining your 7 p.m.
Now, while I'm in the meeting, I can also take other actions like presenting documents. Cortana, present the quarterly review deck.
Okay, which presentation?
The second one.
Sure, I'll bring up the presentation.
Of course, privacy is top of mind. So the Teams display comes with physical buttons to toggle your camera shutter, as well as your mic. So you're always in control. So there you have it. A ton of great Teams innovation coming your way this summer. New capabilities to help you bring your teams together and reduce meetings fatigue, to address some of the known meeting pain points, and lastly, to streamline work and save you time.